Well, peeps, I'm at it again. Definitely, we're gonna be going up this tower. Like, let me tell you something. Something about this Kingdom Hearts collection that just keeps crashing. And I ended up losing my profile for the original part of this game when I started. And this is a whole different profile. So the majority of this game is this all freaking cutscenes. That's what makes this game long. When you pass every single cutscene, this game is really done quickly. Like, it's insane how quickly you can get through everything. I kind of laughed a little bit because I thought it was going to take me longer to get to this point. So the entirety of the gameplay of your what is supposed to be like your first like few hours is really just all cutscenes. So like within an hour, I got to this point. That's not bad when you think about it. The gameplay, the actual game part that you have to do stuff is about an hour. Bosses and all. I defeated Axel like in under like a minute, really. He's like one of, like most of these bosses are easy, and I didn't even like fight most of the enemies this time around to even get to this point, which is hilarious when I think about it. So we're climbing this tower to get up to Master Ying Sid. Wow, we got a dark shard. You know, because it was a whole different run, I could have done a little bit more, but I was like, nah, when you lose footage like that, you don't really feel also compelled to do everything thoroughly. Even when I got money, the odd job that I did the most was just like destroying the trash. That was like the easiest, and that and the mail carrier. Oh, I didn't know I had all these commands. Oh, I didn't just like all these action commands that you could do. Oh, that's fun. Yeah, I know, right?
Well,
I'm telling you, Donald, I'm crazy. Crazy, crazy, crazy. Only way is up. We're going up the tower. Yeah, I know. Oh my god, that's like hardcore right there. Oh, we found Mr. Yin Sid, like sorcerer. Yeah. This is the part where I deleted.
Master Yin Sid.
Yeah.
It's an honor.
Hey there.
Sora, show some respect.
So. You are
He's
Sora.
Technically the sorcerer
well,
from Fantasia.
Have you seen the king yet?
So it's interesting.
Yes, we did.
In
Master,
the first game,
we
went up against the Chernobog monster, which is from Fantasia.
Busy of late. Therefore, it would seem that the task of instructing you three falls upon my shoulders.
You falls upon my shoulders.
You must be well prepared.
Must be.
You mean we have to go on another quest? I was looking forward to finding my friend Riku, so we could go back to the islands.
Yes, I know. However, everything in your journey, Sora, is connected. Whether you will find your way home to the islands, whether you will return alone or with your friend, and whether or not the islands will still be there. And the key that connects them all is you, Sora.
One thing to rule them all. I don't know why I just said that.
Chosen,
I was like, one key to rule them all. Like, oh my god, like I'm in Lord of the Rings or something.
Open the door to light.
I don't know why that came to mind. Maybe I need to watch Lord of the Rings. Nah, I can't stomach it anymore. Can't watch that. I watch silly shit these days. And an occasional seriousness.
Occasional. This book contains valuable knowledge you will need for your journey.
This is why I watch anime. I can't take it seriously.
Once you have finished, we will speak of the enemies you will surely confront.
The enemies of my life. Let me see the beginnings. The beginning. Each journey gives rise to a chance encounter, and each encounter brings forth a farewell. When a farewell leads to a journey, the worlds open their hearts. There are those chosen by the light and those ensnared by the darkness. Friends who share the same bonds, though their paths may differ. When you doubt the path trod thus far, when the hand you held is lost to you, gaze anew at the heart that once was, for all the answers are within. Oh my god, it is so vague as a riddle in my shithole there. Like, why did I even say that too? I don't know. Okay, a long dream, a sad farewell, hanging in the air in that world between. What is reality? What is an illusion? The path chosen by the young boy leads to his memories. When caught in the stream of the days and nights going past, gaze anew at your steps, for there all confusion will end. Why? Why? Let me see. The future story. The future, let's see. Will the day come when this battle, born of confusion, will end? It is different things to different people. Can the reality be that which is hidden? The reason is mere existence. Still, memories can be believed. Why did I just say it like that? Be not afraid. Entrust your body to the soothing waves of your memories. By and by, your fleeting rest will be over, and everything will begin. Am I in the mood today? Shit. Let's see. This is a strange tower. I wonder why it was built. Then this is the thing you're asking, Goofy. Adventuring rule number 8. Search every corner of a new place. Well, thank you, dearie, for reminding me of such... Okay, Donald. We have to read that book, like Master Yin said. We've been asleep for a while, so we need to know what has been going on. The book contains important knowledge. Be sure to read it. Do you have any... Actually...
But wait a sec. How come the Heartless are still running around?
We got both Heartless and Nobodies.
Prevent an immense effusion of Heartless from the Great Darkness. Make no mistake about that. However, the Heartless are darkness made real, and darkness yet lingers in every heart. The Heartless are fewer.
Yeah, that's
while
true.
Darkness exists in a single
but it's a balance
heart,
between Heartless and Nobodies at this point.
To eliminate them.
Gorge, that must mean if everybody's heart was full of light, them Heartless would go away.
Well, how about them Nobodies?
Now, It is time to speak of the enemies that you will encounter.
What in the world?
If one such as you, Donald, yields to the darkness in their heart, they too will become a heartless. But you know this.
Duh.
The heartless are always lurking and ever seeking to capture new hearts. Never let your guard down.
Never.
Now then.
Never. Never do that. There's the nobodies.
At times, if someone with a strong heart and will, be they evil or good, becomes a heartless, the empty shell they leave behind begins to act with a will of its own. An empty vessel whose heart has been stolen away. A spirit that goes on even as its body fades from existence. For you see, no bodies do not truly exist at all.
Well, that's just shitey.
No bodies may seem to have feelings, but this is a ruse. They only pretend to have hearts.
Well, that is
you
making
must
an
not
assumption.
Be deceived.
Oh my gosh.
No bodies. They don't exist.
Now then, the being you see before you is known as
a dusk.
They are the most common form of nobody. But there are others.
They
some
like to dance. You see how they're swaying? They're in a nightclub right now in their minds.
Be vigilant. On your journey, you will meet an alarming number of dusks. They will all attempt to do you harm.
Huh?
Still, they are nothing but empty shells, destined to return to darkness. But...
The damn hooded people that we encountered.
The beings you see before you now are
different.
These powerful nobodies have formed a group called Organization 13. It commands the lesser nobodies.
Organization 13.
Organization 13. What is with the number 13?
While heartless act on instinct,
I guess there's 13 seats. 13
manner.
Heads at this point.
Plan. And it seems they are working towards a goal. What that goal is, we do not know.
Oi.
The king sensed the danger and journeyed forth to fight it. He found the Dark Realm's Keyblade and with it closed the door. Now he's traveling from world to world, fighting the heartless as he seeks the answer to the riddle of the nobodies and Organization 13.
Then I guess we better go find the king first.
But where could he be?
Well, we won't know till we look.
Yeah, and the king must know where Riku is, because the two of them were together in the Realm of Darkness when we closed the door. You know, after defeating Ansem.
So, you will need more suitable traveling clothes. Those look a bit too small for you.
Yeah, Zora.
Through there, you'll find three good fairies. If you ask, they'll create for you appropriate garments.
Oh yeah, the
sure
three fairies from
fast.
Sleeping Beauty. Those are the ones that actually had the... What do you call it? The seamstress skill. They were like tailors. Alright, so let me save this junk. I mean, this is a hell of a view, phantasmic view, as it's overlooking a sea of clouds. Aren't you something? So, I guess we're gonna head this way. Ah, there's the three fairies. What are they doing?
Me? You guys, Riku and the King. I don't care who this organization is or what it's planning. With the five of us, I mean, six of us, there's nothing to worry about, right?
Yeah!
Yeah! Okay. These clothes will help you only as much as your growth allows. The true potential lies dormant. It's your job to unleash it. What? Clothes. Though once you change, you're off. Please, change clothes.
Well, look who's here, dears.
Sora, Donald and Goofy.
Oh, if you're looking for clothes, you've come to the right place.
I'll do the designing.
Oh, that's so cute. Abracadabra.
No, that will never do.
Oh, now, dears.
But don't you like this better?
Hold on.
Are you certain?
Blue.
They're gonna fight over this for a good while. Oh, isn't that Maleficent's crow?
Would you just decide?
All right, then. Together now, dears. And no more squabbling. Oh, my.
Oh, it's lovely.
Finally, yes. We got some color meshes going on. Yeah, I like the color scheme. It's a good one.
Those aren't ordinary garments.
They have very special powers.
I wonder what kind of special powers they have. Because I can't remember too much of this game. Oh, wow.
Two keyblades.
This journey's going to be twice as difficult as your last.
Your garments also have other powers, but you'll have to discover what they are as you continue on your journey.
Okay, I'll do my best. And
that's a really cool looking outfit.
Oh, and there's something else for you from Master Yen Sid.
Oh, boy!
Star Seeker. Valor form. The drive command has been added. The gauge on the lower right is consumed by transformation. Ah. Okay, it is powerful as it absorbs party members' strength, but party members disappear will transform. Okay. Valor form. Okay. Okay. I think we're good. Zora, I think you dropped something. Huh? It must have fallen out of your pocket. But what is it, though? What is that? Part of a picture? Is this a gift, too? Oh, we don't know anything about that. But if you found it in your pocket, it must have something to do with your adventure. Hold on to it. Hold on to it, dear. In fact, you should hold on to any other piece you come across on your journey. I'll make sure to note them in my journal. You have obtained a puzzle piece. Puzzle pieces are scattered all over the world. Some can only be accessed after learning a certain ability. You can view collected pieces in Jiminy's journal. Okay. Guess we're going back to the Sorcerer's Loft. Okay. He's telling us what to do now. Oh, it's the gummy ship.
Hey, it's the gummy ship.
So you guys ready to go?
Now,
just a moment.
Because of your previous endeavors, the worlds have returned to their original states. That means the pathways between them have disappeared.
How do we get around?
Do not fear. If what the king suspected proves true, the worlds have prepared new pathways along which you may travel. These pathways may be utilized by unlocking special gates. How these gates are opened, I'm afraid I do not know. However, the Keyblade will serve as your guide. When a beam of light radiates from the Keyblade, return to the gummy ship. Though the worlds may seem far apart and out of reach, they nonetheless remain connected by invisible ties, as do our hearts.
Well, that's funny.
Our hearts are connected.
That is correct.
Got it.
But be warned. As you proceed, the Heartless and the Nobodies will be using their own paths. Corridors of darkness to travel from world to world. They may be attempting to link these dark pathways to the gates between the worlds.
He's funny.
Now then, that is all the information I can give to you.
All right.
Go forth, Sora, Donald and Goofy. Everyone is waiting
for you.
Okay, let's get going.
Everyone's waiting.
Master
for
Watson.
You. All right.
I do appreciate the help.
Donald, Goofy, we're on the ways. More worlds we're going to visit.
My goodness, what's that?
What's what? Oh, Maleficent's crow. What is that?
Haven't we seen this somewhere before?
Yes, dear. I wonder whose it was.
Maleficent?
No, we mustn't remember her name. Oh, dear.
She was a mean old witch.
Oh, no. The memories are coming back. What'll we do? Oh, what'll we do?
Oh, it's bringing life to the cloth.
Goodness,
Perhaps we should tell Master Yen Sid.
Yes, that's what we must do. Hurry. Maleficent!
She alive? Dang.
Howdy, Sora. How you doing?
Oh, Chip and Dale.
It's your favorite gummy engineers here, ready for duty, Chip.
And Dale.
Wow, they added the voices in.
Happy flying!
Oh my god. So...
Only one?
That's no good.
Wait! I think it's a world we know!
Use the left stick to fly the gummy ship. Try approaching the world at the bottom of the screen. When you arrive at destination, press triangle to land. Okay. Land in Hollow Bastion. Okay.